Hi, I'm Michael Correa, and this is Psych Exam Review. In this last video in the unit on development, I'd like to look at some of the challenges and changes that occur throughout adulthood. Now, it's hard to say exactly when adulthood begins. We might have a legal definition that says on your 18th birthday, you're now an adult, but we recognize that that doesn't really mean that adulthood has begun. And what we consider the beginning of adulthood might vary depending on the time period that we're looking at or in different cultures. So one way we could think about this is to consider the challenges that adults face, and if you find yourself facing these challenges, then you might consider that your adulthood has begun. And one of the first of these is the desire to form a long-term relationship and perhaps start a family. And so there's an increased desire to develop a sense of closeness and intimacy with another person. And adults also must manage new social and financial obligations. These social obligations may be related to work and career, and financial obligations often involve being more independent and maybe even having dependents that you are responsible for. And this might be children that you need to also care for, or it could also be aging parents. Now, adulthood is also associated with a number of physical changes, and one of these is that our physical abilities will peak early in adulthood and then decline throughout the rest of life. And during this decline, it's common to see weight gain, and this is often in the form of fat, because adults also begin to lose their lean muscle mass over time. And we also know that hair begins to thin and gray, and we also see decreases in sensory abilities for vision, smell, hearing, and taste. We also have cognitive changes that occur during adulthood. And while semantic memory tends to stay fairly consistent throughout most of adulthood, we do see a decrease in the ability to access those memories. So it's more common to experience blocking, where you have a memory, but you're not able to retrieve it when you want to. And fluid intelligence also declines throughout adulthood, and this begins earlier than you might think. It actually begins sometime in your mid-20s. Your fluid intelligence may start declining. Now, the reason we don't notice this right away is that our crystallized intelligence is continuing to increase. You can still acquire specific skills and knowledge, and this can make up for the fact that you're not quite as good at solving new problems or coming up with new strategies or new approaches for something. Now, we also see some more severe types of cognitive changes that are more common in late adulthood. So one of these is dementia. Now, many older adults worry about dementia, but it's actually not that common until we get very late in life, if we're fortunate enough to actually live that long. So in adults who are 65 and up, only about 1% suffer from dementia. But once you get to about 85 and older, then you see about a quarter of adults have some form of dementia. And the onset of dementia can occur very suddenly in some cases. And this is often due to a series of mini strokes in the brain. Another cognitive change that many older adults worry about is Alzheimer's disease. And in Alzheimer's disease, what we see is the buildup of what are called amyloid plaques and neurofibrillary tangles. And these are bits and pieces of proteins that get folded and wrapped around neurons and prevent them from functioning properly. And this results in memory problems. It can result in disorientation. It can also lead to difficulties in speaking, swallowing, and walking. And in many older adults, we do see a shrinkage of brain volume. But in Alzheimer's disease, this shrinkage is more severe. Lastly, we can consider socio-emotional changes associated with aging and adulthood. And one of these is a change in the nature of relationships over time, and a shift in a long-term relationship from early passionate love to a more companionate type of love. And older adults also have to confront the meaning of their lives and reflect on the choices that they've made. And one particularly significant choice relates to reproduction, whether they've chosen to have children or not. Because as they get older, they'll reach a point where they lose their reproductive abilities. And this occurs earlier in women than it does in men. This means they have to reflect on whether or not they decided to have children, because now it's too late for them to change their mind. Now, we also see that older adults show reduced concern with acquiring new skills and knowledge. And part of the reason for this is that they simply don't have much time left to use those new skills. And this might explain why perhaps your grandparents are less interested in learning to use some new technology. And older adults tend to be more focused on emotional goals. And that means despite these many declines that we've seen in physical abilities and cognitive abilities, The good news is that as people get older and older, they tend to see an increase in their well-being. And this is in part because of a greater focus on emotional goals and trying to find the things that they truly care about and the things that truly make them happy. I hope you found this helpful. If so, please like the video and subscribe to the channel for more. Thanks for watching.